What a fascinating fight that is to me.
Yeah.
Because people want to pretend Colby can't fight.
I know, right? When someone's a bad guy, it sways everything yes. in their reasonable, rational mind.
It's so crazy.
Watching what he did to Robbie Lawler makes someone so undeniable that it's ridiculous. But meanwhile,
people are still in denial. Yeah, yeah. They're in less denial, though, than they would be. They're in less denial than they would be. It's a real problem. He's a real problem. Because that style of shit talking is infuriating.
Yeah.
And you can't say a goddamn thing to him because he's in a character.
Oh, yeah.
So if he pisses you off, you say something back to him, yeah, why don't you go suck Trump's dick? He'd be like, I would. Mr. Trump's a good man. I bet his dick tastes like lollipops. He can say whatever he wants.
Colby gets it, man.
Listen.
He gets it. He's full old school Ric Flair with a new style twist, and he's a real fighter, man.
He's a real fighter. He's absolutely one of the best welterweights in the world, and this is a very, very close fight. But Kamaru Usman, he's a tank of a man. He's a spectacular athlete. He's got big power. I mean, he only has, I think, a couple knockouts in his career, but it's because he learned how to kickbox after he learned how to wrestle. He was an elite wrestler, but he does put people away.
Colby's my favorite thing to watch right now. I think I think he really gets so many aspects of the basic part of this sport.
Look
right?
at his suits.
Endurance, learn, train, and be entertaining.
Dude, have you seen his new suit?
No.
He's got an orange one now.
Oh.
And he brings that Donald Trump Jr. book everywhere he goes.
I love it. I love it.
He's got an orange suit, just as gross as the blue one. It is goddamn hilarious. There's photos of him at the press conference with an orange suit. Bro, he is. Look at that. Look at his orange suit.
Yes.
It looks like it costs less than the blue suit. I didn't think that was possible. He's a fucking genius. Listen, man. This guy, let me mark my words. When this guy is done fighting, he will be a huge pro wrestling star.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking huge. And he might do it quick. How about that? If that guy wins, and maybe he fights Masvidal, maybe he fights one more time, he goes right into pro wrestling,
right.
And he may cha-cha-ching.
And what's crazy is that I've been pitching, we do a wrestling podcast at the Comedy Store, and I've been pitching for years now.
Look at him reading the book. He's sitting at the press conference reading Donald Trump Jr.'s book.
And I've been pitching for years that the WWE is missing out on having this pro-Trump, super bad guy character, and then Colby comes out of nowhere and does it in real life in the UFC.
And
they still haven't done it in WWE.
And you can't call him a joke.
Right.
Because he smashes Robbie Lawler, smashes Rafael Dos Anjos. You watch him fight, you're like, oh my God, this guy's a fucking beast.
A record-setting performance against Robbie Lawler. 500-some punches landed.
Yeah. Not just that. He mostly beat him standing up.
Yeah.
It was mostly a stand-up fight. And he is the guy that you thought of as the wrestler, and Robbie's the elite striker, he's a former world champion, and Colby ran him over. It wasn't even a close fight.
And all this promo stuff that he does, how good he is at that, it's because he wants to be. It's because he's a learner. He came and saw me perform at the Improv in Florida, West Palm Beach. And afterwards, we were in the green room, and he's like, you know, I learned a lot about timing and beats from watching you up there tonight.
Oh.
You know, getting those, you know what I mean? How you get these laughs using your timing and your pauses and this. I need to do more of that. I'm like, yeah, dude, exactly.
Yeah.
It's so cool to watch a guy that's, you know, while being on top of a big business, I feel like a lot of people, you know, their egos, this and that, or it's just about the fight game, you know.
No, he's not about that at all.
Right.
But it's a genius pursuit. And, you know, he has openly now said it. We talked about it on the podcast, but he's saying it now. He did it on the Candace Owens show. He's like, they were going to cut him. They were going to cut him. They had told him that his style wasn't fan-friendly. And so he beats Damian Maia in Brazil and calls him a bunch of filthy animals. Everybody goes crazy. And they're like, oh, hold on a second. We might have something here. So he talked about it on the podcast. Like, look, I got to do something. My career is in jeopardy. Like, I'm going to create a character. So he created this character. Like, I've called his fights before. Now, I called his fights early in his career. Before that, he was just a really tough guy who had a great gas tank, who I knew from my friend Cam Haynes. He trains with Cam Haynes.
Right.
So just imagine the kind of gas tank this motherfucker must have. If you do anything with Cam Haynes, you have to have a crazy gas tank.
Well, that's the scary thing about him, right? It's almost like, again, it's like a pro wrestling character already. It's like, oh, you don't know?
Right.
Even if you don't somehow find a way to finish it, you're stuck in rounds 4 and 5 now. It's always going to be championship rounds now with this guy, and you're going to be stuck in there with him.
Yeah, if you can't take him out in 1, 2, or 3, and you can't maintain that pace, and if you try to take him out and you emptied your gas tank, he never empties his gas tank.
Right.
And the thing is about his style, this thing that he's doing, not his style, but his promotion style, with the cheap suits and the fucking book, you think it's a joke.
Yeah.
But then you watch his fights. If you didn't have any information about him and his character, and you just watch his fights, you'd be like, fuck, man, this guy's driven. Mm-hmm. This guy's fucking driven.
Yeah.
But then you add into that this character, and then everybody's pretending, you know, that, oh, that guy's a joke, that guy's a joke. That joke, he's running over everybody.
Everybody.
Like, just because you don't like Trump.
Yeah.
And this is like, it's a genius thing to attach himself to Trump.
Right. And what's interesting is like, even fighters that maybe have paid more dues and are maybe are more respected, like if you put them all at the table, like when we were behind, when we were backstage at MSG and The Rock's there and Dana's got the new BMF belt and all this stuff's happening, they were doing that press conference for this one, and Max Holloway's on one end and they have these guys on another, and being backstage sometimes is a blessing because you can hear things that maybe you wouldn't notice if you're out front, right?
Yeah.
And the roars and the cheers and the hoopla and everything was every time he talked.
Dude, we had a good time just sitting there watching it from the sidelines.
Wow.
It was great.
Insane.
It's a what we're seeing is a master class in promotion and adaptation.
Yep.
He adapted, he created this character, and this character is, it's so obviously a character, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. I mean, it's so obvious. He's not wearing that suit on purpose, like he thinks it's good looking. No. He's trying to be a dork.
Yeah.
He's trying to be a pro Trump dork. Like, if I was Trump, I'd be a little annoyed.
Yeah.
I'd be like, hey man, I see what the fuck you're doing. You're making yourself look like a goof because you support me.
And that, please tell me you're following Colby on Instagram, right?
Of course I am.
Oh, the best. The videos with the girls where he just comes out with his hands on their butts. Hey, losers.
Hey, nerds. It's straight up pro wrestling and super high level pro wrestling, like promos that he shoot. Look at this. He's got a Trump hat on, standing in front of Trump towers. It's... Come
and the
on,
style
man.
Even matches it too, right? Because like, if he was just a quick round one knockout artist, almost like, you know, sort of like McGregor-esque, right? I still don't think it works as well as a guy that has a never-ending gas tank.
Never-ending gas tank. And can take a tremendous shot too.
Yeah.
He's a nightmare for everybody in the division. Colby Covington is a fucking nightmare because he seems like he's playing... He's doing these promos with all these girls in bikinis.
It's so...
He's fucking reading Donald Trump Jr.'s book. He's making it seem like he's a goof, and you don't notice along the way that this guy's stomping world-class fighters. I mean, stomping them.
Yeah.
He's fucking amazing. What he's done is, it's like a master class in promotion for all the young fighters coming up. I don't necessarily think everybody should do what he's doing.
Right.
And, you know, but if I was in his camp, I was one of his friends, I would for sure be cheering it on.